Hey guys, you Broker Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool promo, where last time I left off, I defeated Watford in the FA Cup to progress to the semi-final, and I defeated Stoke in the league to win, to secure the league title, with a few games to remain. So now the starting 11, the main squad, is going to be mostly used for the FA Cup and the Champions League. Those of you who did see the last episode, I'm in tough shit. If you didn't, you should watch all my videos, even if you're a new subscriber. Or why did you come straight to this video when you can clearly see 46? Go back, start from the beginning.
Well, there's still a bit to be done in the Champions Cup, but the teams involved are tough. Believe that this could be their year to actually lift some silverware.
But those of you who did see the last of the will know that after the Stoke game, I did have three games in between. After that, but before this, and, I won all three of the games. Instead of simulating them, I did play them, but considering they weren't really relevant, I decided that, you know.
And in goes the cross.
Nothing was regained or lost from the fact that I played them, but I played them off screen. All you missed were three really good dominant wins. The first win was against Brighton, I beat him 4-0. Divock Origi scored a hat-trick, and Roberto Firmino got the other goal in the after coming off the bench, I should specify, because I was using the second team. Then in the game against
and he bangs it away.
Hull, I use my main squad.
Javier Pastore.
And I won 4-0 again. With a Sadio Mane hat trick and a Dava Alaba penalty, which put me in the lead after Hull were reduced to 10 men. Davis was sent off for the foul on Coutinho, which came as a result of a corner from Hull. I countered where Coutinho was in the box, and I guess Davis only saw one option, and it was to take one for the team. Unfortunately, he either mistimed it or just didn't care that it was going to be a red, because it was definitely a red, and the referee did indeed send him off. Alba dispensed the penalty, no ball. That one miss against Stoke. Hope that's something else if you didn't see the last episode. But Alba actually missed his first penalty.
Is definitely odd.
In a Liverpool shirt. That was disappointing. But you know, he's still got a much better goal close to ratio from penalties. He's having only missed one in all the ones that he's taken. He's now scored 11 from 12.
Edinson Cavani. Trying to get it wide, and it was a good idea, but he couldn't find his support.
So, yeah.
Now he's got the ball and a chance to create something. Good position. They've worked this attack very well into a quite a dangerous position.
Really? It's...
Past one defender.
No, wait. 11 from 12 is right. I'm carrying the one from last season because he has 12 goals this season with the penalty against... Hull.
He went in well. Just a little nudge to nudge you in the direction.
Did you see the up and coming fixture against Manchester United? Well, yes, it doesn't mean anything. I still want to show you guys with me beating them and making sure the undefeated streak stays intact.
To attack.
But yeah. And as I mentioned, Sadio Mane did in fact score a hat-trick against Hull to pass 40 goals. Yep, Sadio Mane, he managed to... to achieve it. He finally got to 40 goals. He joined... For players to do that at a Liverpool career, well, for me, he was Cristiano Ronaldo, well, and that was last FIFA. So this is two FIFAs in a row, really three. Well, it would be three seasons in a row had it just been the first season, but it's the second, so. Now Mane is mostly gonna be in. If he plays, in, he might be a part in a few of the games. You're not gonna see the games that don't hold any value. The game, the Premier League games will only hold value when it's time to collect the league title at the end of the season.
Krychowiak, really on top of their game now, wonderful understanding, came in with a challenge, now Sadio Mane.
So yeah, and the third game was a 3-0 win over Swansea, two goals from Roberto Firmino, as well as a goal from Diogo Origi.
I think there's going to be a change for Paris Saint-Germain.
He gave me the win in that match. Which I actually started Origi, I said, give this, see how, see if the Mane and Origi have grown to be a better partnership, because Origi,
strong challenge.
He scored, for the course, the two of the crucial goals against Okay, if you remember.
To see his situation. And on he goes. And they cut it out. Edinson Cavani. Verratti.
So, as I said, I would
PSG, no.
Try one of the games out. So, I'd say it would be Swansea.
Could be in.
Yeah, you repaid me with the goal.
It's the goalkeeper's ball. Cool.
And I made a very silly mistake at the end of the game. Towards the end of the game, anyway. I accidentally slid in on one of the players for Swansea, as I was a bit frustrated that I didn't get the hat trick, so I accidentally had Firmino slide in and he got sent off. So, yeah, so Roberto Firmino can't play against Manchester United. He wasn't going to play anyway, but he can't play. Even if I wanted to, he is banned for that game. So, no Firmino against Manchester United. It looks like PSG may hold out. Oops, going the wrong way. I can't have that. I think it's safe to say I'll be playing the second leg in this tie as well, which is weird because this is the first team. Minus Roberto Firmino now because he's gone off for Feyenoord.
No doubt that they want to get the substitute on now, Paris Saint-Germain. It's 82 minutes played now. There's going to be a throw in after that tackle.
Are you freaking kidding me?
Oh, it's still goalless here, not much time left. What about their next game, Alan?
Well, Liverpool go up against Manchester United. It's been a hard match out here, but certainly they haven't reached the levels they have in previous games.
Coutinho. Sturridge.
Sturridge. Mane.
Oh, he's through.
Okay. He gets a goal. Oh my god, that's the second time he's hit the crossbar! Mane! Third time is the charm! Sadio Mane finally gets to go. Oh. Well, so we're gonna win the first leg, but it's not gonna be any kind of comfortable margin.
We've got a winner now, a fantastic late goal.
Well, you have to think that it is a winner as well, Martin. Very little time now for the opposition to come back.
By any stretch of the imagination.
Well, a very exciting climax to an exciting game. This could be the decider.
Well, it could be at this stage of the match. There doesn't seem much of an opportunity to come back.
And the second leg will definitely need to be played.
There will be a minimum of 3 minutes on each team.
It's like barely time to even get a second goal, let alone enough goals to comfortably win this leg to where the second leg would be unnecessary. So, PSG, he did lose to me, but they survived to get me to play them again. And in the next episode, I don't know who I have after that. So that means I'm gonna have to put in another league game. Oh no, Spurs are the semi-final against Spurs in the FA Cup. That's the game after the second leg against PSG. So I don't have to put in the games against Bournemouth and Leicester, or Leicester and Bournemouth. Order makes any kind of difference. And the semi-final, the first leg of the semi-final will probably be somewhere around. No, actually, it'll probably be the first week of May, wouldn't it? So, I don't think the West Ham game will get rearranged. Maybe it will. Maybe the first year and the ninth. That was a Wednesday night, so maybe. I don't know. We will see. We shall see. We shall see. But, let's focus on going into the game against Manchester United. Oh, yeah. Almost forgot. Is that confirmation? Just to. So you guys know I'm not trying to pull your leg about the suspension for Roberto Firmino. I made a very silly mistake, but it shouldn't be an issue. It really shouldn't. I should be able to deal with this absolutely no problem whatsoever. Why not? I'm gonna throw in Laforte instead. Fayor in goal. Of course, I'm referring to the goalkeeping. It's so confusing having two players the same name. And I don't know both their first names, so it's not like having two both Torres. You wouldn't be able to. You can tell. The only way I can tell the two Fayors apart is one is a outfielder and a winger, and the other is a goalkeeper. That's the only way. I don't know their first name. Anywho, let's get into this game and pick up another win over Manchester United just because I can.
It's match time. Martin Tyler here and Alan Smith with you as always to describe it. And we're looking forward to something special today.
Well, I think so, Martin. I hope these two teams won't disappoint us.
This is the Liverpool side. So, Alan, 4-4-2.
Yeah, I think it looks that way, Martin.
A nice early goal would help with the start of the match. And then might come. Oh! The return ball to Moore was cut out by Darmian.
Antoine Griezmann, the main striker today. Take over possession again. The break is definitely on. Nothing wrong with that tackle. In fact, it was a terrific.
Yeah, I suppose it's not Damien because there is an R in it.
Building on the best defence.
Well, defending is an art and sometimes a forgotten one in this day and age, but this lot haven't forgotten.
But we all know it's the Italian version of Damien, right?
Attacking.
I've never heard anyone in English speaking country called fucking Darmian.
No hesitation. The yellow card's coming out even this early.
How did Bali get away with that? How was that not a red card? He fucking acted me down. Let's see. I don't exactly have a top quality penalty taker. Unfortunately, it's not David De Gea. And Steve Origi takes full advantage of that. No idea where De Gea is. It's a Romero in goal. Despite going the right way, he is unsuccessful in preventing Origi his penalty.
Manchester United on the move here. And it's now with Liverpool. Chris Smalling. Fellaini.
Smalling. Is it to Darmian?
The home team with all the cards here, it seems.
Say that.
Especially the points that they got for winning.
More.
Ground of the opposition here.
Makes his way into a box. Beautiful finish. Emery Moore makes it 2-0.
It should get them across the line at the end of the match. We'll see. Just look at the way he's got past these defenders. And a really match maximise the situation he created for himself.
Well, he did. He was head down and some wonderful balance.
It's not as important as his season, his near end season goal against Everton in season one, but it completes. It's the next chapter in the legend of Emery Moore. Just making sure he is gonna go down in history by scoring against all my rivals. A goal against Everton and a goal against Manchester United. It's like the perfect double hat in terms of goals. Was for a Liverpool player.
As
Diawara goes in, joins Eric Bailly in the Oliver's book.
Was optimistic, but he was quite close.
Wasn't far off, was he? Maybe the keeper would have got to it, but decent strike.
A very soft yellow card, compared to what Bailly did. I still think Bailly should have been a red, especially if that's a yellow. Bailly's challenge was way worse than that.
Attack building for Manchester United.
Good tackle by Ragnar Klavan. And getting straight away. Me back to Birmingham.
The opposition around with their play at these two players.
Paul Penga.
Oh, he's beaten his marker.
That would be probably, you know, that would be more funny if
that's a fine
if we hadn't been fucked over.
But when he's hit
in fact, irony is, it was actually Oliver who fucked us over. He was the referee in real life, if I remember correctly. Yeah, it was. It was Mike Oliver. Motherfucker. This game. That is not a fucking coincidence. This game has some fucking shitty humor.
They were in otherwise.
When I saw it, first time of asking, I thought he was on, you know, but looking at the replay, what a good decision from the linesman that was.
Looking good, this move. Now Bailly. The board has gone up to indicate three added minutes. Griezmann. Now Anthony Martial. Half time now, and 2-0 is the score at the.
I was going to say what happened, but I think it's half time. It is indeed. It's so hard to tell. I wish there was, like, you know. Oh. Why does career mode not have subtitles? Like, it have, like, subtitles that only, like, I could see?
Griezmann. Goal news involving Bournemouth.
It's a second goal for Crystal Palace. It's been scored by Christian Benteke. That's his second today. There was seemingly no danger, but...
Could pull one back
here. Fellaini! Oh, how did Bushy Head himself not equalise for Manchester United there? I'm not even gonna lie, he should. Oh, sorry, it's 2-0. he should have brought them back into the game by,
Crystal Palace.
Pegging a goal back.
Movement. They're getting forward here, Manchester United.
Completely forgot what the scoreline was there. Where I thought it was still 1-0. I'm forgetting your goal there, Emery! But I apologize. Please.
Won it back with an interception. We want to just tell you about EA Sports.
They're very sloppy. Game passing wise. The Moore isn't gonna get the. Probably he's stopped 3 or 4 fucking times. That's when I was telling him to run.
It's a
It's going to be a third booking. It's yellow for Fellaini this time.
Decision, and the decision is yellow.
So a central mid. So that's two central midfielders in the book and one central defender. Fellaini and Bailly for Manchester United and Diawara for me.
Scoring opportunity.
Yeah, I mean, it was a good position they fashioned themselves into there. And, he did go a fraction of a second early. He was off.
Challenges for the ball.
Just saw something. Is Valejo? He is. Valejo is playing. And I signed Valejo using Fusa Mensah, the player I controversially signed from Manchester United. But something was pointed out to me, and it's not the first time I've done business with Manchester United and Liverpool Grimm. And to be honest, Ings will probably end up one way or another, and it won't be the last. I mean,
this could be it.
Oh, Joe, 3-0. Oh. And you could see Fellaini's reaction. He's probably like, no, I could have made it 2-1. Now it's 3-0. Oh.
They've just run away from them, and they're likely to do that in the match if they keep playing like this.
Yeah, such a dangerous side on the counter-attack because they move the ball from back to front so quickly.
Given them a comfortable situation here, 3-0 as the game gets underway. Substitution, and it's Manchester United to make it.
So a lot of these guys are scoring their first goals in the league.
They cope with it well defensively.
Oh, shit! I completely fucked up and Griezmann gets a shitty goal. I freaking gifted them. What was I doing? I freaking...
Goalkeeper, nowhere to be seen.
No, he just seemed to...
I thought he would completely get past... I thought Laporte would kick it past Martial, not straight at him. I mean, you know... Oh, use your eyes, you know. You have two of them, you fucking idiot. I know that is, I'm not letting myself off the hook, that is my mistake. But for fuck's sake, you think the computer would be like, yeah, I'm gonna not do that because there's a dude standing right in front of me, or, you know, throw it over him.
Well, there's still time if they can get this goal.
Who's someone in a red jersey, they can clip it further down the pitch. It's and that goal doesn't have to happen.
Great work by the goalkeeper. The ball is his, and he's made sure he's protected it. Looking, oh, he's through.
More 4-1. That was counter-attack. In football at its best. It's Manchester United pulled too many people hurt for the corner. The ball ended up with my keeper, her. And I couldn't get the people they needed back in time to prevent Emre Moore slaying it home and making it 4-1. You know, you can have your shitty consolation goal from Griezmann. In a way, that makes up for the goal they should have gotten from Fellaini earlier. And I'll take Griezmann over Fellaini. Really? That's another yellow card. Another really soft one as well. Go fuck yourself. Let's actually look at that. Wow! Really? Really? That... Baze definitely should have been a ref. That's a yellow. Oh. That is complete and utter fucking bullshit.
Referee has indicated there will be a minimum of 4 minutes.
He's hit the free kick. I'll never be afraid to shoot.
Hey, Pogba missed.
Emre Moore. Here comes the challenge.
Rigi.
Look at this. I know he fancies himself. That's a win confirmed for Liverpool.
I was trying to get something, but didn't end up that way. 4-1 is the final score. And even with the second team on the pitch, I completely decimated Manchester United. They got the consolation goal. Oh, and they did deserve a goal. I'm not going to debate that. They deserved the goal. Fellaini, I don't know how he missed. Well, probably because he's Marouane Fellaini and not, you know. If the initial shot had been from a Griezmann or a Martial or someone like that, they would have probably scored then. But, you know, in a way, before anyone even thinks it, I didn't intend that to happen. That was a complete and utter fuck up on my part, or 100%. But you know, it is a goal they did deserve. I will give the literal devils those their due.
On the team above, bottom of the table, Brighton and Hove Albion
on this occasion.
Then reading up the table,
Aaron Flane should have gotten them their consolation goal. They got it through an error of mine team with Anton Griezmann. So, did it make any shred of difference? No. Will it make any shred of difference come the end of the season? No. Am I still undefeated against Manchester United? You bet your fucking ass I am. So, that's the end of this episode. My recordings of Liverpool remote for the weekend. Until next time, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. Smash the like button if you did, subscribe if you do. Until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.